Earlier this week, a boiling hot spring linked to an intrusion of magma appeared inside a house in an area completely absent of any similar geothermal features, filling it with steam. This occurred in the same area which across the last 10 months has seen another boiling hot spring suddenly appear beneath a second house alongside the appearance of 5 patches of unusually warm ground and 2 patches of steaming ground. All of these newly formed features were determined to be volcanic in origin, being powered by very hot rising magmatic gases. And this occurred within Indonesia's portion of the island of Borneo, which itself has not been the site of a single volcanic eruption in more than 250,000 years. Well, I now have new information and corrections to my prior video regarding what we initially thought to be a fresh and ongoing magmatic intrusion rising through the lower crust at a depth of 16 kilometers. After all, I checked for signs of ground deformation and found none, and the reason for that is because, as it turns out, this magma was not actually new. Instead, the heat originated from a body of magma at 14 kilometers depth which has likely existed for many tens of thousands of years, possibly even hundreds of thousands of years. Although we do not know exactly how old this cooling body of magma is, we have a good idea of an upper bound in terms of age, as at the approximate location shown on screen is what is likely to have been a largely basaltic andesite volcanic field at one point that has since almost completely eroded away beyond easy recognition. A combination of lava rocks and pyroclastic rocks, albeit primarily ash deposits from this unnamed middle Pleistocene volcanic field were recently dated, being determined to be between 400,000 and 500,000 years old. So, could a hypothetically 400,000-year-old body of magma at that depth still be cooling and thus degassing because it somehow hasn't fully solidified yet? Actually, yes, but only if this involved a truly massive intrusive body of magma, in other words, a batholith. Batholiths at the depth of a known body of magma fully cool from the outwards in at a rate of about 1 centimeter every year. Thus, a body of magma would need to be at least an 8-kilometer-wide sphere for our hypothetical to be true, which isn't that too far outside the realm of possibility. However, it is seemingly more likely, at least in my opinion, that the body of magma causing this is still a batholith but far younger, perhaps only being 100,000 years old. Okay, we've established that degassing from this deep and large body of magma is powering these hot springs and fumaroles which just appeared. So, why did geothermal features only appear now if the magma had truly existed for tens of thousands to hundreds of thousands of years? The answer is the thick underlying claystone rock unit which acted as an anticline, which this entire time had been trapping the gas released from the underlying batholith. So, are we now dealing with the possible release of hundreds of thousands of years worth of magmatic gas, meaning that many more hot springs and fumaroles will soon appear? No, not exactly. Magmatic gas given alone enough time will combine with and thus alter surrounding rock units, removing it from its gaseous state. However, if enough gas accumulates before it's removed, then a specific threshold of pressure is reached, suddenly creating fine cracks in overlying rock. Magmatic gas then rises through regional fault lines. Some of this gas subsequently reaches the surface to form fumaroles, while other portions of it interact and heat groundwater, causing the water to rise and forming boiling or near-boiling hot springs. However, these features were not long-lived as the same cracks which allowed them to form are soon after closed due to lithostatic pressure, once again trapping the underlying magmatic gas. This is why these geothermal features have been forming and disappearing since March 2024. It just wasn't widely noticed by locals and reported on until recently. Regardless, there is absolutely zero chance of a true volcanic eruption occurring with this new information since the magma in the batholith is inactive and slowly cooling. However, the reason how this magma was emplaced in this section of Borneo within the last million years is worth investigating because not only does circumstantial evidence suggest an unusually high abundance of similar features in the lower crust in this outlined area, but the mantle itself is about 50 degrees Celsius warmer than it should be in this area. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Robin Christmas, for supporting this channel.